Hello everyone, hope all of you are well. This is Lopa Mudra Dev once again with another video. So let's start today's session with a motivational quote. Today's quotation is by Winston S. Churchill. He quoted, "Success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts." So you should not limit yourself by achieving one goal. You should extend your potential to achieve more and more in your life. And your failures should not demotivate you. You should not be demotivated by whatever failures you will be experiencing, because it's your effort, it's your courage to move ahead will be ultimately count, and surely your courageous moves towards the path of life, towards your goal, will all obviously be take you to the peak of success. So wish you all the success in your life, and hope you will keep all these things in your mind while struggling for reaching your goal. Okay, so let's start today's topic. Today's topic is philosophical foundation of curriculum. I know some of you are very much disinterested in such topics related to philosophy, but I'm sure that after attending the session, you'll find interest in such topics. So before starting in this particular session, I'll be putting some light that why the curriculum developers or educator, they consider philosophical ideals in the process of curriculum development. Why various philosophical thoughts are taken into consideration to make a successful planning of curriculum. First of all, let me tell you, I think you know about John Dewey, one of the very renowned philosopher. He quoted that education is the way to life. His philosophy is always realized that when the education is put into practice after acquiring knowledge, when an individual will face the real world, how those practices will make him or her in successful leading of life, that is the ultimate goal of education. By providing education, teachers actually they build the man who will be the future country builder or society builder or nation builder, you can say. So it's utmost importance that the student should be provided with such knowledge. That knowledge will ultimately help him or her be a productive member of the society. So for that, nourishing of their values and ideals are very, very important. At the same time, the stakeholders like the students, the parents, they will be very much clearly known about different aspects of education. The clarity, the accuracy will always be the foundation or core founder of the education. So ultimately, while to provide proper education, proper foundation of curriculum is very much needed, and without implementing philosophical thoughts and ideas, it is impossible. Okay, and the thing is that philosophy always offers solution to the problem, the administrators of an educational institution, the curriculum makers, and the teachers, because the particular society always reflect the philosophical ideas of the particular area or the particular community to which the education is provided to. So for that reason, philosophical ideals are very, very important, and it should reflect in the whole curriculum. And philosophy always clears the way, it paves the way so that educational objectives, both specific and general objectives, more importantly the general objectives, can be achieved and proper methods, practices can be implemented to achieve the ultimate role or ultimate aim of education. So let's see one by one that how various philosophical thoughts are influencing our curriculum from time immemorial, from right from thence, that is your Vedic age or the ancient days. Whenever there is education, every time if you go through the educational processes of various era, you will find that the philosophical thought of particular ideologies are always reflected. So how various philosophical thoughts, they have clear influence in the educational system, which is provided through a well-planned curriculum, you will be understanding from the further discussion. Okay, so first let us start with idealism. I think you have clear idea about idealism. The idealism, it's derived from the word idean. Okay, so idealists always stress more emphasis on mind and self. Okay, so they have strong belief that the creation of the universe is an reflection of mind. So emphasis always given on mind. That's why according to idealism, always the aims of education always that is emphasized on self, because mind of an organism is very, very subjective. It's the way, how do I think? It's my mind that decides that how will I think. So to know how my mind is working, it's very, very essential to know about the self. So the aim of education according to idealism is to attain self-realization, to achieve the highest potentiality of the self. That means the thing, the capabilities, the abilities an individual has in that is very, very important. And also idealism emphasizes on preservation, enriching and transmission of culture. Okay, and idealism has put more stress on moral sense, develop inventive and creative powers, and also aim to achieve the idealistic philosophy, so that an individual can be morally developed, an individual can take rational decision in its life, and an individual can enrich the cultural environment of a particular era. Okay, that is the main aim of education. So nowadays in our curriculum, moral science is very, very important, because no matter how educated you are, how skilled you are, but if you are not morally strong, because you know Osama bin Laden, he was a very literate person, but still he was morally not strong. That's why he did many immoral works. That is just an example I have cited. Around you also, every time you will be finding many such examples, you will be witnessing many such people, those who have many potentialities, but because of their lack in moral sense. They are, as human beings, they cannot take decision morally. Okay, so which is in great demand of the current situation. And that is, idealism always put emphasis on not only on aesthetic or moral activities, but also in intellectual and physical activities. That's why if you see in our day to in our current curriculum also, this reflection are there. We have socially SUPW classes, we have physical exercise, we have yoga, we have games and sports. All these things are to make someone physically strong. Okay, as I told you, it's compulsory to have moral science classes, make someone morally high. Okay, aesthetic activities are also very, very required. For that, various subjects like drama and art are there, paintings are there, vocal and instrumental musics are there to make someone that is aesthetically potential. At the same time, various subjects like mathematics, grammar, then your social science, then politics, logic, all these subjects are included in the curriculum. It should be there in the curriculum by according to idealistic philosophy. At the same time, idealistic philosophy also offers some methods of teaching, how teaching should be transacted from the by the teacher to the children. So idealists, they always emphasizes on some particular teaching methods like inductive deductive method, question answer method, storytelling, lecture method, because according to various idealists like Socrates, then you know about Plato, they all have emphasized on such topic that make so that the teaching method can transmit the knowledge clearly to the children. At the same time, it gives the children that is, it make the children to be sufficient enough so that they can clear their confusion by continuously interacting with the teacher. Okay, so I think as one of the very renowned Indian ideologist is Mahatma Gandhi, and when I saw SUPW, then his name came in my mind. He also always talk about three hands, three H, that is heart, head and hand. So according to him also, if when we talk about hand, it comes to physical activity. When we talk about moral and aesthetic activities, it comes to that is your heart. And we talk when we talk about head, it comes to our head. Okay, when we talk about intellectual activities, it refers to head. So that is the reason that all the idealists, whatever idealist philosophers are there, they always emphasize on full-grown development of an individual. Now let's go to the next one, naturalism, which is again has great influence on our today's educational system. Naturalism always that is considered nature as the ultimate reality. They emphasize on nature, natural instinct, natural characteristics of an individual. So according to naturalists, that nature is a dynamic entity, it keeps on changing. So human beings should also have the ability to adapt with the changes in their own nature, so that they can adapt with the changes in the outer environment. So that is the most important concern of naturalism. Okay, they always put emphasize on developing the natural instinct of the children with the help of education, and they always emphasize on senses. They always say that senses are the gateway of knowledge. That means whatever knowledge a child should get, that should be with the by their own experiments. They must learn whatever they learn, it should be by experiencing, by using various sense organs. So the major aim of education according to naturalism are self-expression and self-preservation, transformation and modification, better adjustment, struggle for existence. I think you, those who specially come from science background, they know about that, Darwin's theory of existence. And then achieving individuality and social progress. So naturalism emphasizes on individuality. To being an individual, one must have the ability to be to prove it himself or herself as fit, because the one who is fit, that he or she only be will only be survive. Okay, otherwise survival will be difficult, and to survive we need to continuously struggle for our existence. And those who can bring changes in themselves and can make themselves fit in the process of adaptation will only be survive. So the adjustment, to bring better adjustment in an individual, to retain the that is own instinct, own potential, all those things should be the aim of education, and which is again has great influence, and which is again are very very important to lead a successful life. And to achieve all those aims, whatever subjects that are suggested by naturalists are science, mathematics, language, social sciences, agriculture, carpentry, drawing and art, physical and health education. You can see that most of the subjects that are mainly related to physical, physical, to develop physical activity, that is potentiality and intellectual potentiality. Because naturalism, they said that these are the main thing that can lead, that can help an individual to lead a successful life, who can that is provide assistance for both social and national progress. They said about in international brotherhood also. And for like we are now in an era of globalization, where all whole world is under the same roof. So that feeling of international brotherhood, along with preserving the self identity, preserving the self qualities, are very very important. So naturalism is also a very important ideology that should reflect in the curriculum. Okay, and the method that are suggested by naturalists are direct experience. That, as I said you, that the whatever they said, that and according to naturalists, the senses are the gateway of knowledge. That means whatever knowledge one is getting by directly experiencing them, observing them. At the same time, playway method, heuristic method, like discovery, something that they discover, all those things. So for this reason, teacher needs to provide an environment where children can express themselves fully. So that is a very urgent need of successful educational structure of a particular society. If we keep the children under pressure, we cannot expect them to be innovative. We cannot expect them to be heuristic. They will be submissive. So being teachers, that also curriculum planners, that also has to be taken into consideration. Okay, so let's move to the next one. Pragmatism, the key word of pragmatism is action. They always believe in doing. Okay, so curriculum, according to pragmatism, they mainly emphasize on creating values of life, construct knowledge, construction of knowledge, other than imparting. So nowadays in our faulty educational process, teachers, they mostly emphasize on imparting knowledge. But the thing is that knowledge should not be imparted. We should make the children able enough so that they can construct knowledge by their own. And this is the characteristics of an innovative person, an invention. How do invention take place? The inventors, they construct knowledge. They don't utilize the knowledge that are simply imparted. Okay, they don't expect, they don't accept all such knowledge. Okay, and they also said that the learner should be equipped with social efficacy and adjustment to make the learner effective member of the society, which is very, very important according to pragmatism. And pragmatism also, supported the holistic development, that means balanced all-round development of an individual, not only intellectually but also spiritually, then physical development, physically, morally, all kind of a balanced personality should be there. A person who is emotionally, spiritually, morally, intellectually, physically balanced, that person will only be successful in their lives. You know, nowadays emotional intellect, intellect is very much, emotional intelligence is very much lacking in the children. That's why often we listen about various suicidal cases. You know about that one, the Bollywood star Sushant Singh. He was intellectually very high. He was an intellect person, but maybe he was emotionally not that intelligent. That's why he won't be, he could not balance his emotion and took such a wrong decision. So that is why, along with making someone intellectually and physically potent, we need to emphasize on holistic development, where an individual can handle all the adversities in life by using various kind of intelligences or intellects. Okay, and like naturalism, pragmatists also prefer that knowledge should be earned by doing activity. They like giveaway method. Okay, like experience, they, while doing an activity, whatever experiences they get, and that knowledge only lasts for long. That's why they always said about doing something, action. Then whatever aims are emphasized according to pragmatism, to achieve those aims, they suggested the subjects like language education, science, geography, agriculture, physical education, home science for girls, art and craft, all these subjects should be there in the curriculum. Then only all those aims can be achieved. And these aims are also the aims of our current, these aims are also in demand as per the current situation. So all those subjects are useful to achieve aims and the methods they said, as I just said you, that like learning by doing, project method, discovery method, inquiry method, etc. are should be there in the curriculum. Then only all these aims that are very, very important and practical for an individual to manage the better management of the life activities are very, very important. Okay, now let's move to the realism, which is again a very important idealistic philosophy, a philosophical thought, where they mainly said about the materialistic world. According to realism, there is no existence of abstract thing like soul, God, spirit. They don't accept their existence. They simply idealist philosophers, they simply believes in those can be seen with the naked eyes, those can be experienced by touching, by using the sense organs. And the key word of naturalism are here and now. That means whatever here at present and whatever we can experience, that are only real, rest are all unreal. Okay, so realistic aims are to produce an individual capable of handling the world affairs, bring a well-adjusted individual. This is the aim which is the one of the most emphasized aims of all the philosophical thoughts, because this is very, very important. If an individual is not well adjusted, if an individual is not having endowed with a balanced personality, it will be difficult for an individual to face any adverse situation and overcome that. So that is very, very important. Along with that, realists also emphasize on the qualities like sociability, intelligence, morality, robust health, so as to develop a complete man. That means all intellectual, moral, physical activities are given importance. Okay, so next is to prepare for a happy and successful life. When an individual will have balanced personality, when an individual will be able to manage all his potentialities, manage his emotions, his moral values, principles of life, thoughts and ideas, along with the physical health in an optimum way, then only we can say the person will be happy and successful in his or her life. And that is also very, very important. At the same time, earn of livelihood, which is very important. To be a productive member of the society, we must have vocational efficacy. That vocational efficacy will help us to earn our livelihood, also to contribute the social progress. So for to achieve those aims, thus that is your subjects suggested by the realists are mother tongue, science, mathematics, economics, history, geography, law, political sciences, astrology, craft works, farming, because these are very important. Other than having idea or knowledge about all those things, whatever aims are that is prescribed, those aims can only be achieved by including these subjects in the curriculum. So nowadays we have agricultural universities, we have astrological centers, we have all these subjects where a person can do specialization also. So these all reflect the idea of realism in the curriculum. and realism. Realists, they advocate inductive deductive method, then experimentation, observation, field trips. These are very, very important, where a children can an individual can acquire knowledge by using their own potentialities, using their senses, and those knowledge are regarded as having a high impact on an individual. And this knowledge acquired by such methods are regarded as very long lasting. Along with these three main idealistic thoughts, nowadays curriculum also reflects some other ideological philosophies like perennialism, focuses on classical subjects, then literacy analysis, then essentialism, where main emphasis is given on three R's like reading, writing, and arithmetic. Then progressivism is another philosophical thought which is in practice nowadays. And reconstructivism, which is highly important, because whatever along that is with the changes in the societal structure, with the changes in environmental condition, various national and international issues have also arisen. So to cope with such changes, reconstructivism is very, very important, and all those things must be included in the curriculum. So just an idea I have given you with this video related to the topic philosophical foundation of curriculum. This video will be helpful for you. Please do like and share the video, and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get regular notification, and I'll be pleased if you give your valuable suggestions in the form of comment, so that I can bring some changes and modification in my videos. So let's wind up today's session. Wishing you good health. Bye bye.